Welcome to the new episode of Statistical Computing. In this session, I am going to discuss about independent and dependent event, conditional probability, as well as the theorem of probability. Let's see the independent event first. The two events said to be independent event if the occurrence or the non-occurrence of the one event does not affect the probability of occurrence or the non-occurrence of other event. So here let's say the event A and B represent as the head and the tail while tossing a coin, right? So event A or B, both the events are the independent event. They may not affect any other event, right, while you toss a coin. So both the results are independent. They occur or non-occur by their own. It's not depend on any other event. So the next term is the dependent event. The one event affect the other event. So the dependent event, when occurrence of one event affect the probability of the occurrence of other. In case of two dependent event A and B, B can occur only when other is known to have occurred and vice versa. Let's say event B is occurred when event A occurred after the event A occurred. So before the event A, event B cannot occur. So that means event B depends on A, right? So independent event, there comes the conditional probability. So you need to find out which event is depends on which event. Let's say B depends on A or A depends on B. So the conditional probability, if B event depends on A, the probability of the occurrence of B occurrence of the event B denoted by the symbol B by A, and that means the occurrence of event B depends on A. So if A occur, after that B event will occur. If A cannot, so B cannot, right? So the occurrence and the non-occurrence of event B completely depends on A. That is the dependent event and the conditional probability denoted as B by A. The next we have, that is the theorem of probability. So the two theorem we are going to learn. The one is additive law of probability. It is also known as the addition law of probability. Here we have two cases. If the events are mutually exclusive and if events are not mutually exclusive. So if events are mutually exclusive, so the law is P of A plus P of B plus P of C. Let's say if we have three events. So the result is P of A plus P of B plus P of C is always 1 in case of mutually exclusive event. All three events are mutually exclusive. If events are non-mutually exclusive events, so in case of two events, let's say P of A plus B is represented as P of A plus P of B minus P of A into B. This formula we have applied in my previous video where I have discussed 20 marbles in a bag and which are numbered from 1 to 20. The marble drawn at random, find the probability probability that the numbers on marble is multiple of either 2 or 5. So the common values 10 and 20. So finally we have deducted from A plus B, right? So you know this formula, the rule, or we can say the law or the theorem very well in terms of non-mutually exclusive event. If three events are there, let's say P of A plus P of B plus P of C. So the formula is P of A plus P of B plus P of C minus P of A into B minus P of B into C minus P of A into C plus P of A into B into C in terms of three events. And the note that the additional note I have noted down here, at least one event will occur. So in that case, the non-mutually exclusive law of additive will be applied, right? So remember, at least one event will occur out of the number of events. So this is the additive law. Let's see the multiplicative law. So the multiplicative law is also known as the theorem of compound probability. If the probability of occurrence of event A in trial is P of A, and if after the occurrence of the event A, the probability of occurrence of another event B will occur, then the probability of occurrence of two events with true trials in case of independent and dependent event. If the independent event, so the in case of multiplicative law, P of A into B is equals to P of A into B. And in case of dependent event, P of A into B is equals to P of A into P of B by A. This is the conditional probability. It means P of B depends on the probability of A. So the occurrence of event A depends on the occurrence of event A, we can say, in terms of dependent events, right? So this is the multiplicative law. So you have to remember in terms of, if we have the term in the question, let's say either or case, right? So I'll write here or, right? So for or term, you have to use addition, right? For the additive law, remember the term or, right? And for the multiplicative law, you have to remember the term and, right? So when it says event A and B, and when it say event A or B, right? So A or B, so additive law, A and B, so multiplicative law, remember it. Right, so if multiplication, so it denoted as intersection, let's say A intersection B, and if additive law, right, so it is A union B, right? So that's it. Thanks for watching my video. We'll meet soon in the next session.